Hello. It's another wonderful Tuesday evening. Good day to start up a new game here. So this is Bloodstained Ritual of the Night, or rather a subtitle screen for it, because it brings up this little title screen here when you go into the game's classic mode. So Bloodstained Ritual of the Night is a Metroidvania game in the vein of Castlevania. It's one of those kickstarted by the original creator things, because the actual company that owns actual Castlevania doesn't want to actually make Castlevania anymore. But this mode, classic mode, turns the game into a Classicvania style game. So more along the lines of like Castlevania's 1-3-4, Rondo of Blood, all that good stuff. Now what I'm going to do with this actually requires use of ye olde Konami code, slightly altered so that it can work with modern controllers, but since not all modern controllers have a B and an A button to hit. So let's just go ahead and do that real quick. There we go. They even did a little sound effect jingle that was reminiscent of the Konami pause sound. So this is 1986 mode, which is going to make, from my understanding, I actually haven't even tested this yet at all to see how it plays, should make the game play basically exactly like Castlevania 1. So that includes limited mobility, especially in regards to jumping, since original Castlevania, you could not change your jump trajectory at all mid-jump. So it definitely has that. But anyway, let's get going so that there can actually be some audio in this stream besides me yapping. I hope the volume levels are okay, because I could not test them. Anyway, gonna be playing on hard difficulty, taking this all the way. I'm also not sure how much, if any, of the story of the game since survives the translation into classic mode. But here we go. Loading's taking a little bit. All right. And yep, only whip straight forward. Got ourselves a throwing dagger. I think the game might be a bit too loud. Let me actually go ahead and pull that down a bit. All right, folks are gonna have to let me know how that is. But I think we should be good. Wonder if maybe I should move a little so you can see the fact that this isn't just a black screen. There is a little loading icon there. Taking a bit longer to load than I'd like. Just interesting. I don't remember having load time difficulties with the regular game. Yeah, this is a lot like the first stage in Castlevania 1. Okay, can I make it up the stairs, please? I tried to do the jump up part way, and I don't know if I'm allowed to do that. I'm enjoying this so far. It's a nice little throwback. Okay, we got our holy water. We even go to a water area just like the start of Castlevania 1. And there's food in the walls. Oh, ew. Can you please not be standing there? There we go. I think it's actually kind of funny that they went through the trouble of making this game mode, considering... Okay, no, you can't get on the stairs partway up. You have to start from the bottom, alright. But anyway, considering that they like, in the lead-up to Ritual of the Night coming out, they actually made a full-blown Classicvania-style game. Did a little misjump there. That was called Bloodstained Curse of the Moon. Which I actually own on Switch. I might play that sometime too. Hey Seth, how's it going? Bone. Is bone... Yeah. So bone is like the throwing axe. So far, it's the only sub-weapon that has been different than its Castlevania counterpart. Also, if this were a true... If this were truly Castlevania 1, that fall I took there would have been death. Sub-weapon, maybe? Oh. Ah! Ow! Game, please. Why you gotta flashbang me like that? Ah. Okay. Duly noted. I will go ahead and give a warning the next time that item comes up. Good God. I'll take the axe over the dagger. Yeah, right? The first boss is even a giant bat. Oh, I think I'm happy with keeping the bone, then. Got him! Stage one down. Got your King Buuite height card, Seishun. And yes, a reminder for everyone who, or for people who may not know, we do have a 1-point channel redeem. It's sort of a daily check-in thing. Roll rolls a random trading card of one of three. Oh, I think this is a loading screen. It's just not giving me an icon. But yeah, one of three rarities, common, rare, and shiny. We have had a shiny come up on stream, finally. We have had one come up. Loading times could stand to be a bit better. All things considered. I don't remember them being this bad in the original. Like, when you just play the normal game mode. Good God. Alright. Oh, my camera just slid. There we go. Hopefully that's fine. Oh, holy water. Ah, there we go. Just ignore the bats. Oh, I don't have enough stuffs for holy water. All right. That resets after the stage. Okay. Makes sense. It is a pretty major thing in a lot of the classic style Castlevanias. Some enemies are just better dealt with by dodging them rather than trying to hit them. Ooh, I'll bet this is the boomerang cross. I don't have enough stuffs to use it, but... hello? This part's breakable. Oh, hi. Secret things. For points! Because you know score is super important in games. Within the past 30 years. We're getting Medusa heads already. Seems a little quick. Hey, guy. So, funny thing is that knight character, in the main game for Bloodstains, there's actually a version of it that is blue and is made to look like Shovel Knight. Because all of these indie games gotta have Shovel Knight in them. I mean, Shovel Knight's fine. It's a good game. But, good God. Everyone's just like, Shovel Knight! And what is this? Time stop. So it's like the stopwatch. Oh, I see. It's a hand of a clock. Okay. I actually didn't understand what the actual thing even was. Baloo. I could become Baloo. Dabba-dee-dabba-die. So what is the point of coming over here? Just some of that, I mean, to be fair, some of the classic, Castlevanias had completely pointless platforms in there. Ow! Level design. I couldn't see that one before I collected it. Oh, when did I get a dagger? The worst sub-weapon. Ah. app. You fuckers. Okay, I see you, bat. Huh. You don't care about me yet, though. Now it will. Gah. One hit away from death. Oh boy. Didn't make the jump. Oh well. I wonder if getting a game over makes me have to restart. Nah, I'm liking this so far. But I am also quite the fan of the Castlevanias, so... I like the base game, too. It's really good. I would say my only problem I have with the base game isn't necessarily a problem with the game itself, but a problem with how I wound up playing it. Alright, flashbang incoming. Is there was a certain weapon in the base game that when I found it, I became absolutely addicted to it and just couldn't play the game with any other weapon after that point. Even as stronger weapons made themselves apparent. Ooh, that's actually really useful for those. It stops the stage hazards too. Oh, that's nice. But yeah, anyway, the weapon is a flying sword sort of deal. And what made it so, I guess in my mind, overpowered, or just the reason I liked it so much, was the fact that you could use it without stopping your movement at all. So you could just spit out a flying sword that would zoom out and then, like, do this arc back to you. And there are two versions of it in the game, a base version, and much later, a somewhat stronger version. And that stronger version is what I wound up using throughout the rest of the game after getting it. And just the fact that you didn't have to stop to use it at all. Because every other weapon, like, you couldn't use while moving, which is, frankly, to be expected. But the fact that there was a weapon that could be used while moving and the damage on it, especially if since it could hit multiple times with how it worked, it felt a lot better than a lot of the other weapons I could use. So I think if I was going to play Bloodstained again, I would avoid that weapon. I was holding down, I should have been kneeling. At least, unlike the dragon heads, it destroys both of them when you're done with them. Go. There we go. That's how we kneel. Is there a sub-weapon here? Is. Nice. And it's a good one. Last time? Yep. Brr! Ow. I don't... Wait, how am I meant to dodge that? Ow. Petrifying eye. He's so fast. Ow. All right. So game over is just start the stage from the beginning. That's fine. I can deal with that. Keep moving. Don't worry about the bat. Yes, it does appear that with classic mode, we are completely ignoring the story, which is fine. Story's not important. Points item. I know it's useless, but for some reason I can't resist it. Hey, buddy. Checkpoint. You know what? I'll get the time stop. Proves itself to be a hell of a lot better than the stopwatch in Castlevania. I don't think that stops stage hazards. No dagger. Crap. Yeah, Miriam here, she just goes down like a lead balloon over those gaps. But it's what I signed up for. But good old Simon Belmont did. Dagger. All right, that chandelier was the flashbang, so we avoided it. Oh. I should not have jumped like that. Crap. Gonna have to redo this level solely because of bad platforming. Yes, yes it does. Gravity was Simon Belmont's biggest enemy. Ugh. It will be Red Miriam's greatest enemy as well. I say red because she's normally like blue and purple. Her colors change when you do 1986 mode. Ah! Crap. Ten out of ten platforming. I can understand why anyone watches me. It's for quality gameplay like that. Okay, again, if this were actually Castlevania 1, that would have been a death. Because Castlevania 1 does that thing where platforms that are below the screen cease to exist. I think if you want to see some good examples of that, you go find my VOD for when I played Castlevania 3. During the Castlevania-thon back in the day. That really was like forever ago now. I do still have other Castlevania games to play too. The Castlevania-thon could continue. Because I only played the canonical games. There are, to my recollection, off the top of my head, 4 or 5 non-canonical games that I haven't touched on here. I did a Let's Play of one of them way back in the day, but, You can't see that anymore. These days my YouTube just has the VODs for my current streaming. I took all of the ye olde Let's Play footage down. To be fair, I think aside from a few highlights from when I played Metal Gear Solid, I don't think you guys are missing much by that not being available anymore. And flashbang. Don't screw this up. Yeah. Oh, hey. Alright, 6 hits. Oh, you son of a bitch. But my time stop. There he is, Mr. Boss. Go get this boomerang. That I have very limited uses of. Alright, boss man. The trick is you just gotta kill him fast. Don't get bogged down in dodging, just lay into the motherfucker. Alright. I think we're going to be on the screen for a bit here, folks. If last time is any indicator. There we go. I want to keep the boomerang. Okay. I see. Ah. Curse you and your weird patterns. Get out of here. Sick of your shit. Oh, dagger. Can we not have the Medusa head analog in every level? Please. I'm so tired of it already. Fine, I'll take the stupid bone. Through the platform. Oh. What a weird attack pattern that thing has. Jump button. Donde está the jump button? Those bone throwers are a lot more beady than I thought they would be. Game? May I please land on the platform? Good, Miriam. Okay, fine, I'll take the hit. Stop again. I have one hit left. Let's go. I see. I actually died to running out of health. How about that? I need to take fewer early hits, is the problem. Like that, too. That was kind of dumb. Ah, well, that was fucked. That was just a big middle finger to me from the game. Thank you, game. You know how much I love your middle finger. My god, that whole display there looked like I knew how to play video games. Don't get used to it, folks. Yeah. Yeah, I was pretty thoroughly fucked there. And that's right before a checkpoint, too. Oh, that's rough. Go. Leave him behind. Knife. Completely miss the wasp like three times. Good shit. Just move. Okay. Checkpoint with no extra lives. Let's go. I think that's what killed me last time, too. If it wasn't that, it was something like it. Stairs, please. Please just whip the goddamn wall. I don't ask much from you, Miriam, but I just need you to be able to strike the enemies with your weapons. Surely that's not too much of a favor. My god, I actually made it to the checkpoint with some lives. Stop right there, monkey. That's kind of ass. Not worth it. Move, move, move. And that's another death. Thank you. Listen, Wasp. Listen, shitheads. All right, sure, fine. I don't know how to avoid taking damage from that wasp. Move upwards. Okay, holy water, that's something. This is a dead end. Oh boy, a one up. Will I live to get back to the other side and use it wisely? Amazingly, yes. Get out of here. Bye-bye. Time for clone fight. Yep. And it's a gank fight. Oh, but they have really, really simplistic movement patterns. I can also just holy water both of them. And just destroy their health bar. Got it. Oh. That was a surprisingly fast loading screen, all things considered. Alright, so let's go up here. Seems sensible. The holy water is quite useful, though, I gotta say. Ooh. Oh. Oh. Oh, I see. That's... Ah. All right, then. Why did I jump there? It's all right. I just have to, you know... Get all the stupid moves out so that the correct moves can happen. That's how it works, right? I don't like this. Oh well. That was a bit of a dumb situation that I got myself into. I was hoping that wall would break. Duck down. Jump. I think I want to go the other way. The bottom path seems extraordinarily dangerous. Oh my god. Hold on. Too many enemies on screen at once. Great. Well, at least it didn't kill me. I swear I hate these wasps so goddamn much. There we go. What is this? This secret easier path that it just gave me for no reason. Oi. Ah, you fucker. I hate those guys so much. They're way worse than the bone-throwing skeletons in Castlevania. The wasps are terrible. I hate them. They're the worst enemies so far. It's just in this, it's just because their pattern is so goddamn weird. Like, the amount of time they move when they move is different. How they move is different. Like, they're very unpredictable, and that makes them really hard to deal with when the movement, when the character movement is like this. So with the slower, more methodical character movement, you have to be able to kind of like, you have to be able to plan ahead what you're going to be doing. And those wasps kind of throw it out the window. Because they're extremely unpredictable. Unless there's something I'm just not seeing. Who knows? Maybe their AI is the most simple and basic thing ever, and I'm just a dumbass. It wouldn't be the first time. I'm glad we copied the Castlevania physics all the way down to knockback applies based off of the direction I'm facing, not the direction the attack came from. Please kneel. That was a death anyway. Also, I'm noticing a trend here. So far, the stages have been harder than the bosses. By, like, a lot. I wonder if that's gonna keep up. Thanks, Wasp. That was 100% luck right there. You will never see me pull that move off again because that was absolutely luck. That was amazing. I wish I could pull that off. Like, on purpose. Go. There we go. Yeah, I wonder why they put this here. Good job, Vite. Had to make sure to jump up into that. Didn't want to not take that damage. That is a rough jump. That's a jump you can make. I think it's got to be pixel perfect, though. Yeah. Last time? Quite apparently. We needed just a little more stage before we give you a boss. God, it's one of you. And here I am without a boomerang. Boomerang would absolutely tear this thing apart. Checkpoint. That's still not... Ooh, this is a long level. Let's just ignore you. Oh. Get your ass down here. Yes, thank you for hitting me on your way down. Wow, thank you for hitting me on your way out, too. Suddenly you don't want to break when I'm next to you. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Wasp. How am I not able to hit it there? That's the other thing about these wasps, is they can reach that, like, perfect point where they can hit you on a platform, but you can't hit them. Bullshit. That was close. Come on now. Is there a sub-weapon up here or something? The dagger. Thought I was gonna reach the platform. Oh boy, we're gonna still be here a while, aren't we? Well, just like the old Castlevanias, you play it until you get it perfect. Fuck you too, game. That was bullshit. I forgot to wait to see where the little squiddly was gonna spawn. Now I'm really fucked because that wasp is still there. There we go. Hey, Saku, thank you for the raid. How's it going? How was your stream? Whoa. Yes, welcome in, raiders. For anyone unfamiliar with me, hello, I am dying in a video game. I am Vite Height, the Bear Wizard, the Wizard Bear. I play video games on the internet, and, yeah. Sometimes play really hard games, because I like a challenge, even if it really annoys the crap out of me. Added cat goodies to your throne and did your normal clears and Moonfire. Ah. Fear on 14, mostly. Alright. Good stuff, good stuff. But welcome in. So, right now we are playing Bloodstained Ritual of the Night in 1986 mode, which turns the game from a Metroidvania-style Castlevania game into a Castlevania-style Castlevania game. And anyone who knows about Castlevania will know what the hell I just said. Anyone who doesn't know about Castlevania would probably be confused by that statement I just made. But rest assured, it makes sense. Oh, and to anyone else who either hasn't seen it yet or is new, I do have a one-point channel redeem that is basically for the sake of a check-in. Brings up a little trading card with a dumb illustration of myself that will probably look horrifying. And they come in three different rarities. Ah yes, you got the John Monster Rancher card. Like I said, they are all horrifying caricatures of myself. Most of them I did draw on stream before during some art streams. Which I do need to get back into doing sometime soon. You got the Volvite Gia card. Yes, they are based off of, the art concept was cursed cosplays, so it was all just, video game or anime characters or whatnot that I just drew myself as, and that was bullshit. Anyway, they are now a series of collectible PNGs that exist only for mere moments. Available in three rarities. There will be other series coming out too. I will want to keep it fresh with different sorts of drawings. What am I up to Friday? Undecided. Doesn't necessarily mean I'm free for something. Undecided. Purely meaning 100% undecided. Good. Hate these wasps so much. Alright, well, if I have time, I might stop by. I do want to do more stuff on stream with more people. Maybe one day I can, have you do what I did with with a Babinka Bear and run you through the old executive suite. I actually legitimately want to get more people to play that too. I don't know why I love that shitty little text game so much, but I do. Yeah, Saku, do you think you have what it takes to climb the 1980s corporate ladder? Okay, Wasp made it easy that time. We'll see if we can make it work sometime. Yeah, I legitimately do want to take some more people through that. Oh, that's a one-hit kill. That's the first time I've gotten hit by one of those. I didn't know that'd be a one-hit kill. Oh boy. Also, I swear there's more to this level than this section that I'm stuck repeating. I've been to it. I've seen it. There is a promised land of rest of the game beyond this section. I assure you. That's a hole. Fantastic job, Miriam. I really do have to be more proactive on killing the enemies there. I keep trying to just run through and it's not working. Get this wasp dead. Come on, guy. Got him. Walk off that ledge. Out of here. Ascend! Ow. That's the opposite of ascension. It's some kind of weird de-ascension. Guy. Maybe I will keep the time stuff. Oh, lucky. Hop. Okay, wasp is here. Ooh, careful. Of course, the time I keep the time stop, I'm dealing with the enemies no problem. Look at that, perfect. I just wish I had an extra life or two. Just skedaddle. My god, it's the next area that I've been to once. For these birdmen, throw dogs at me. I have no idea what the point of that upper path is. This is why I should have kept the time stop. Okay. Yeah, keep either the time stop or the boomerang. Don't fall for this holy water trap. Take this lower path so we can scoot on under this one. Alright, we can now finally see what's beyond those. This is the furthest I've made it in this level. Oh, finally boss? Finally boss. And now we get to do the whole stage over again. Okay, holy water is actually good for the boss, though. But the boomerang would also be good. Okay. Oh, the wasp wanted to make it easy today. All right. But this guy didn't. Okay, next wasp. Beautiful. I wonder what's in those candles. Get to the end without dying now. That's not without dying. That's the exact opposite of not dying. Oh well. Holy water it is then. Really? Fucking really? Good job, guy. Wonder if there's something good in that candle that you have to go way out of your way for. Can you even make that jump? Huh. Also, I've noticed something. That's, when our character here, Miriam, is standing at the very edge of a platform, her standing pose changes. This is what it defaultly is in the base game. Interesting. No, get off the stairs. Damn it. Cool. Full health, all of my lives. Not going to fuck up colossally this time. And I have the boomerang. This is the run. Definitely the run, I can feel it. Huh, there's food there. I just move. Go, 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 go. Get past the stupidity. Only the boomerang only makes contact on the head, huh? Well, that's different from its the Castlevania enemy that it's like. Actually, no, it's not. It's just that it the Castlevania enemy liked to move around more, so the boomerang got into position more. Oh, I really need health, but that's not gonna happen. Well, bone it is, I guess. No. You do not get to take out my entire goddamn health bar before the boss. That's a fireball. Just go. We get to do the whole stage again, folks. So maybe the boomerang isn't the play. Maybe after all, time stop is still the play. Get through the stage with using as little of it as we can. Got it. Oh, fuck you, man. No. Get out of here. You know what? What is in these candles? I have to know. Points and a screen clear. That's it. That's all that's in this. Why would you go out of your way for that? Yeah. Well, no time stop for me. So now it's try to get holy water through. There we go. Okay. Get past all of these dog drops. And we can use some holy water on the boss. Indeed. I have no idea what that does, but I could sure use some health. Unfortunately, I don't think there is any health here. Not unless I get lucky and have these snakes drop it, if they can. There it is. Grin. Do grin. There's grin for ya. That was gonna be it. How I match the background, okay. But man, that was gonna be the run. I'll hydrate in a moment. At least now I know that food is there. Alright. Hydration has occurred. Boss time. I have full health. That's, the only thing I got going for me. Yeah. And yes, I know, it looks like I'm playing like ass against that boss, but you have to understand how the controls work with this. Everything is very slow and deliberate. The only way I can, like, truly explain it well is if you've played either this or the original Castlevania. It is slow and clunky and methodical. Thank you. Listen, asshole. It went into a good position at first, now it's being a dickbag. Come to think of it, the control thing is also the only real way to explain why the wasps are such a huge problem. Oh, that was luck. To wind up on this platform and not falling into the abyss. God damn it. One of these days I have to actually grab that. I love the sound that that makes. Such a good power-up noise. Okay, but I'm doing better at least. Beautiful. Checkpoint. And I have time stop still. All right, cool. Perfectly fine. Time stop doesn't work on bosses. How unfortunate. Here, I have lost connection. Well, that's a problem. Let's see if it gets better. My internet out entirely? No, it's not. Am I back? I appear to be back. All right. Okay, we appear to be back. I don't know what that was, so I didn't seem to lose internet. Maybe connection with Twitch was just bad. Either way. Fuck out of here. Oh, all right. Is that telling me I'm gonna have two bosses on this level? I think that's telling me I'm gonna have two bosses. Oh, screw your bone throwing. Oh, axe armor. Such spiky armor. Such high defense. Like the axe throwers in the first Castlevania all over again. I suppose that's the point, huh? I wonder if this is also going to end with a shitty gauntlet of those guys. That's what the final stage of Castlevania 1 is. Just a shitty gauntlet of axe throwers that have way too much HP. Alright, time stop. Ooh, big money, big prizes. It had to be Wasp. Not that it mattered, the Wasps weren't what did me in anyway. With the bone throw. Whee! Get rid of you. Nope. Get lucky with where he moves, I guess, is the answer. go. Ignore the Bonemans. Want the time stop. Specifically for this. And I guess it'll be helpful for the wasps too if I have enough for it. One of these days I'll get that jump right. I think the wasp just left. Huh. How nice. So I think the same strategy can be used for these axe armors. Just always duck and hit them. Because if you're ducking and they throw down, you'll hit their axe, which will get rid of it. And if you're ducking and they throw up, then their axe is too high to hit you. The checkpoints matter because I don't have any extra lives, but hey. Look at this bullcrap. Oh. No more time stop. All bone all the time. This is gonna be rough. Oh man, Miriam gets ground up. Why am I facing left? Oh, it's because I tried to duck, but I was close to the stairs. Oh, that wacky Castlevania. Later, Snake. I don't know what the jump is there. Oh. Hello, one up. I don't know how to properly do that jump though. Seven hits. Okay. Good job, Vite. That was exactly when you should pull your head back up. The axe is right over it. Yep. That's how we win video games. By deliberately getting hit by attacks. You're so smart, Vite. I can see how you managed to clear the entire Dark Souls trilogy and every canonical Castlevania game. You know, with smarts like that. Yes, Bear, I have good brain. Good brain, Bear, have. We all know that I only won the Dark Souls games because the games wound up feeling bad for me, so they just gave me a pity win. Because that's what Slave Knight Gale does, is give you pity. Okay, and the one-up respawns. That's excellent, actually. See, that one I'm not so sure about. Sekiro didn't seem to have a merciful bone in its body. Am I the only one seeing this? I appear to be dead, but I'm not. That's absolutely an empty health bar. You know what this is telling me? We have a Mario 64 situation here where the health bar is more complicated than just the pellets that were being shown. There's like an actual value there. And so my current health is, even though that last pellet should only go away when my health hits zero, that means my HP value is probably some sort of a fraction because of how damage calculations work in this mode. Because you have to remember, it's working off of the engine of a game that HP is a, like, a whole number and isn't just a bar. That's my guess, at least. But doesn't matter to me, made it to the checkpoint. Did the game finally catch up? Because I absolutely died to nothing there. Wait a minute. There's something here. Why is there something here? Why is this here? Ah. Secret points item. Of course I'm gonna go out of my way for that. Oh, we're dropping again. We're actually dropping frames this time, too. Fascinating. All right, time for me to check again. Did I lose internet? I sure did. Well, we're just gonna have to hope it comes back. Yep. Yep, yep, yep. So, oh, wait. I think it's back. I think it's back. It appears to be back. Eh? All right. No, it's getting lost again. Now it's back. Eh? Come on, internet. Make up your minds. Are you fucked or are you not? It's gone again. One moment, folks. Let me see if I can get this sorted out. All right. We appear to be back. I was disconnected so long that Saribot thought that I had stopped streaming. Oh, that's funny. Anyway, let's keep going. I said, let's keep going. The Discord bot. Yes. Saribot did not have any faith in me coming back, apparently. But I showed it them. I'll just hope I stay back. There we go. Okay, you have just enough time. Alright, sure, get knocked onto the platform. That's fine, Miriam. Ooh, boomerang. Nice. Very nice. Yeah, I thought that was about to go away. Ooh! Good thing these gears are nice and wide. Uh-oh. That's no good. It doesn't even make sense for there to be wasps in a clock tower. Didn't die. That's the important thing. Okay. Get that boomerang back. How big is this godforsaken clock tower? Did you keep the damage that was done to you? Did he have any damage done to him? Or did you reset? Woo! Good fall. Yeah, that's rough. That's a rough setup there. Did I get an extra life from points? I think I did. That's hilarious. I suppose there's one thing about these the hazard, like the gears, is that since this isn't regular Castlevania and the screen scrolls downwards, they're actually a lot less of a threat as far as their potential to just drop you. Since just falling down is not a threat in this game. Unless it's, you know, a pit. Then, whatever. But in this case, it is a vertical level. I'm not in a good position. Thought I could use the invincibility to get past it. Huh. The cat only show up once? Get your ass up the stairs. I would complain about the Medusa head type enemies again, but this is actually the stage they belong in. Mass dragon again. Let's try that again. I'm not good at fighting those. I've never been good at fighting the original version of the enemy in Castlevania either. wonder if I'll ever get that, zero HP glitch going again. That was pretty funny. Especially since the game did eventually agree with me that I should be dead. Oh, damn it. The one up. Got the knife by mistake. Oh well. It's not too bad of a checkpoint there. Like, that first section of the stage isn't too bad. It is kind of interesting how... Oh. Hello, jump button. It is kind of interesting how coming into the room initially and respawning here after death gives us two different camera heights. Almost back to that stupid dragon. Huh? She's doing her pose like she's at the edge of a thing, and she refuses to walk off of this. Oh, and changing direction. Oh. Are you feeling okay, game? Oh. Alright, we're back to normal now. I see, this classic mode is held together with some pretty shoddy materials. It's fine. Oh, I don't know what I was thinking. There. Definitely can't jump that far. All right, dragon. Dead. I got whatever the hell these are. That cannon appeared to be facing the wrong direction. Hey, food. They made the wall really obvious, though. Ooh, holy water. I'll take that. Oh my god, is this gonna be the final hallway in Castlevania 1? Because that had Medusa heads too, I'm pretty sure. Heal. Okay. Oh, boss time. Ah. Hello, lady. Lady, does Death know you stole his moveset? Oh, hi. Okay, that's not part of Death's moveset. I was about to say, does Death know you stole his moveset and are using it less effectively? And then she had a second move. So yes, and excuse me, it wasn't the final hallway, it's the hallway right before Death in Castlevania 1. So yes, we're definitely making a reference here. It's just not as bad. If you could stop backing up, that'd be greatly appreciated. Alright, come back, lady. I actually don't remember this boss from the base game. Not doing very well either. This is no good. This is very not good. One hit from Death. I'll get this. What? Why can I even use these stairs? Like, let's be honest. What's the point? The point, right, would be to go back and get this food? Eh? Okay, full health this time at least.
Ah, come on. Woo! Damn.
I can get her. No problem. Why are you such a coward, Axe Knight? Okay, sure. Couldn't get through that room without getting hit yet. Nope. Okay. No time stop. We found out it doesn't work on bosses, which, to be fair, I should have expected. That might be a little overpowered if it did. Just go. Ignore the stupid dragon. Except... huh. Nah, I can't reach him. That would be kind of funny. Throw holy water, but I guess that works. Still don't know what's in that candle. Get them points. Yeah, let's get this boomerang. See if we can save that. Bad. what I wanted to do. Especially since I'm willing to bet he's gonna reset his HP. Oh. Well, now he's definitely gonna reset his HP. Okay, so there is a range at which enemies respawn. Damn it. Don't fall through. There we go. Climb up. Attack the cannon that they put in the wrong direction. What's over here? Well, killing that guy has the added benefit of making it so he can't hurt us when we're trying to get this wall curry. One health. Game, where's my boss? It didn't want to let me fight the boss with the boomerang. Understandable. I would have stood too much of a chance. So I think that's the third glitch we've found so far in 1986 mode. There she is. How nice of you to join us, lady. Well. Standing over any of the hands. Oh, she's almost dead. Yes! Oh, fantastic. There's a long loading screen. Ba-ba-ba-bum. It's positioned right behind me too, so you folks don't get to see that. A little pixelated crystal flower. I'm sure the game will be up in just a moment. Hey! The birds are dropping monkeys. Bone, huh? I feel like I would have rather have kept holy water. Yeah, I had to go out of my way to get that too. It's just like, yeah. Bone! Alright, sure. Don't hit the bat. He actually got his axe in between my whip swings. I'm actually really happy I don't have to do the previous level over again. Like, ever. Bone. The monkeys are a lot more annoying than the dogs, I gotta say. Alright, what do we got? Another one of you. I'm just gonna go. Like, this really tall staircase I see. I guess it's not that tall. Oh, hey. Yep, we appear to be at the end, folks. Hey, not Dracula. How's it going? Ow. Okay. Yeah, that's the way to handle that. What's this? It's a boss with a reasonable attack pattern? Oh, I say as he pulls that shit. Did he restore health from that? Ow. He sure does. Wow. They never even thought to let Dracula restore health from, grabbing and biting you in Castlevania. Oh, jeez. Hi. So all of his attacks do seem to have pretty big tells. So I just gotta make sure to never be close to him when he's about to do his grab move, which is that. Oh wait, do I have to hit him in the head like Dracula, or can I? Yeah, I do. I can't go for body shots. Oof. Gotta watch for when he does that. But will he have a phase two? He probably will. And what self-respecting final boss wouldn't have a phase two? I wonder if I can jump over him if I'm just unfortunately too close.
Gotcha.
Come on. I mean, it's what Dracula would do, too. Hello. Right, I forgot about her. Yep, just angrily stomped back up the stairs. That stupid bitch. Alright. I want to get this dagger. It's a better thing to have than the bone. I think two hits is all I can get in each round, maximum. God, the fact that he leans back when he does that has saved him so many fucking times. Oh. Right, that was a bottom first. Also, you know, but you're gonna have to, you're gonna have to get past him without getting hit at all if you want a good shot at, what's her name? Oh, of course. That time, he didn't fade away in time. Oh, and now, unlike when I played the actual Castlevania games, I'm not gonna be able to do save states at the boss. Thankfully, the level is not very long or difficult. In fact, this music is very, like, I'm just kind of now realizing it's very reminiscent of the final stage music of Castlevania 3. Definitely a an homage. Oh my god, monkey, please. Also, speaking of things being an homage to the actual Castlevania games, I have to see if there's some sort of secret spot with a whole bunch of stuff at it. Because that was always a thing. So odds are pretty good there's one in this game somewhere. And I think it might be at the end of this hallway here. I think it might be down here. This. Around where that weird fireball is. Got hit by the bird. Good job, spear guy. Nah, there's actually nothing there. So that means there's just a weird little fireball sitting there for absolutely no reason. Huh. That bird just dropped that monkey down the pit. Wow. Under the dragon, and bada bing, bada boom, we're back here in Dracula land. Well, not Dracula, but you know. All right, buddy. I hate the fact that he leans back when he does that move. I didn't expect him to do that move again so soon. I didn't mean to duck, I was trying to jump over him. Not doing so great. I do want to see if you can jump over the blood suck move. Seriously, they didn't do a final secret stash of any kind. That's kind of lame. There's no way they didn't. I just have to be missing where it is. Hi. The room is so goddamn big. Oh, come on. No, you can't jump over him. All right. So if you are caught too close to him, you're just fucked. God, the stock fire sound effect. Just whoosh. I also don't know if I'm going to be able to finish this tonight, which is unfortunate, since I'm right here at the end. Come on, you bastard. Alright, Miriam, I need you to crouch when I tell you to crouch. Like, this is absolutely vital to this boss fight. Out crouch. All right. Oh. Gotcha. One more hit. Yep. こうなっては仕方ありません。 Do I have to kill these? I think I do. Oh god. Woo! All right. She's a bit spicy. What are you doing, mate? Fighting the axe armor is all wrong. Nice try, Spearman. That's why I wasn't ducking, okay. Still really weird, those little fireballs. Wonder why those are there. Send that monkey straight to hell. Let's go, Miriam. Dying after getting hit in the knee. So, yeah, I mean, it is with a sword whip, so there's at least that. But he is wearing armor. So what's that armor doing for him? Tinfoil armor. That would be a good prank to pull. Yeah, Vite, you need to do better than that. Oh, wow. I may as well not even try now. Come on. I'm not surviving second phase at one health. Ain't no way. I love how awkward his jump from that throne looks. The potential to get three in when he does that move. If it's a down first. I knew he had to. He hadn't done it yet this fight. I was like, where's the charge move?
ては仕方ありません。
All right, I think I have an answer for basically everything but that ice attack. I just need to get to it so I can practice it. No, my kneecaps. And not only that, he bursts into flame after being hit in the kneecaps 7 times. Oh, fuck you, game. Like there's even any good like hidden weapons here. That's bone, which you can get just outside of the boss arena anyway. I'd actually really like a holy water. I think that would be damn good against phase two. I'd call the phase two lady by name if I remembered what her name is. I don't even remember what not Dracula's name is. I get one try at half health and another at full. I think this is the play for the dagger. Oh. I don't think I would try to get more than one hit in on when he does the charge. I'm getting better at him, at least.
こうなっては仕方ありません。
Ah, mistimed the jump. And we're having more connection problems. Well, isn't that super? Connection didn't drop entirely, but... maybe that's a sign that I need to pack it in for the night. But I'll at least go for maybe another try after this if this isn't the last one. Japanese gym. Okay. So the Bloodsuck is definitely the least likely move for him to try. I got phase one pretty nicely. I say as I get hit right here at the end. Oh well. It's too early for me to be allowed to have a perfect run yet. I got an extra life because of the points gotten from him dying. Oh, is that all there is to an ice thing? Wow. Okay. Lady, you just gonna sit there? It's gonna keep whipping you in the knees. Oh, that's a shield too, I think. Well, shit. Hey! It all came together. I just had to believe in myself. Ha ha ha! Let's go. Hey, she returned to her normal color. And, you know, classic load-bearing villains. I don't think the castle even gets destroyed in the main game. Alright, well there we go. As the game suddenly gets a lot louder. That was Bloodstained Ritual of the Night 1986 mode. Just a small taste into the visuals of... Yeah, by the way, that's a backstep move we would have had if we only played on classic mode instead of 1986. So yeah, just a little taste into the visual stylings of the actual game. But that was fun. I think it's funny how many glitches we discovered just from regular playing and not even trying anything, you know, too crazy. Like, I wasn't going out of my way to break the game or anything. And yet I found Miriam standing on the platform wrong. A zero health glitch. And a boss just outright not spawning. But it was fun. It's a fun little side game. The fact that this was provided in a free update too just kind of makes it a little better. I wish I could have gotten a boomerang to that boss fight. Now, am I likely to play the actual game on stream? Probably not, because I've already played through it once before. But I highly recommend it to anyone who has not played it and enjoys Metroidvanias. I was going to say, how close are you going to get to the camera, Miriam? There was someone named Curry the Kid in the credits. Hey, classic mode result. That's the amount of time it took me. So, total deaths, 82. I love how many digits you get for deaths. Do they honestly expect someone to die that many times? Alright, so that's the times for each stage. Stage 4, without a doubt, the hardest. I mean, look at that shit. Alright. Well, that is Bloodstained Classic Mode, 1986 mode, on hard difficulty. Completed in one session. Not bad. So that'll be the end of things tonight. Next stream, I'm not going to be streaming Thursday as usual, so my next stream is going to be Saturday at noon Pacific, where I'm going to be lining up another difficult game, and that is Celeste, which I have not played before. I've seen a little bit of gameplay for it. I know it's difficult. I'm looking forward to it. Anyway, I haven't decided what I'm going to play this time next week either, so we'll see. And yes, the Discord server, if you wish to participate in polls to help determine content for the channel, this game was actually selected via a poll. Anyway, let me see where I can send you guys off to tonight. Who is streaming right now? Ad break, you son of a bitch. Twitch. Well, I'm going to send you guys off to... Screw it. Let's say Eros. He's playing Elden Ring. Looks like it's Elden Ring with the boys, so... Go say hi to Eros for me. Anyway, thanks again for watching. Hope to see you next time. And I hope you have a good rest of your evening. Bye-bye.